Welcome back to the Erfinder Chef, ladies and gentlemen. We're here for episode number 4. Really excited to be here as always. My favorite part is planning the next episode for you guys to watch. So with all the recipes that have been going up and the episodes and the feedback and the comments, it's been it's keeping me going. It's keeping me like on board. Like, what can I make for you next? I'm really excited. We're here for episode 4. We've got another beautiful classic for you tonight. So we're going to get started straight away because we do need to put some stuff in the oven and get some stuff going. First things first that we want to start with is a drink for myself, obviously, and a bit of a promo to one of our Brisbane breweries here. So with my glass in hand, tonight we are having a nitro milk stout, which is provided to us by the Sea Legs Brewing Co. here in Kangaroo Point. So I'm really excited to try this one. I'm pretty sure I've had it before, but I just thought a beautiful, nice milk stout. It's gonna go with our meal tonight. So let's all look at that dark color, almost like chocolate in a glass. I'm very excited. This one is a little bit stronger. Just keep in mind of that, ladies and gentlemen. This one is it's 6.5. Let me just double check the front of the can here. I know it's 6 point something. It is a 6.5. I was right. Excellent. All right. So cheers, guys. And thank you for coming back to episode 4. And we'll just have a quick sip here. That is absolutely delicious. Perfect way to finish a fantastic day. And also the perfect drink to get us through this delectable recipe we're about to go through. So let me not keep you waiting on that. So tonight's recipe, we are going to make a French lamb cutlet, also from a rack rib. So we're going to be cutting and Frenching a rack rib, which I'm really excited about. We'll be going to do some charred fennel, some whole grain mustard charred apple, and we're also going to be pairing that with some roasted baby potatoes, which we're going to pre-boil first, and they're going to go into the oven with the lamb rack. And to finish it off, we are going to do a mint creme fraiche. Now, that does sound like a lot of elements, which is why I said we're going to get started straight away. So I've actually preheated my oven in advance for this episode to as high as it goes, which is 250, and let's get started by prepping some pots for our water, for our vegetables, so our potatoes that I'm going to do. So I'm just going to grab a pot with some water and put it on the back burner. Not too much because I've only got 4 potatoes. Now the rib, the lamb rack that we have, we're going to cut it into 4 portions. Why am I grabbing a silly knife like that? We need one of our beautiful knives here. So I'm just going to cut these in half, really straightforward. I'm just going to put the potatoes into the water and get these on the pie straight away. All right, I'm gonna turn this on and get this prepared. I won't touch it this time, I promise. I know it works. Oh, that's going down way too well. All right. So we're just gonna put some sea salt flakes, our favorite seasoning, into our water here with our potatoes. Excellent. The next thing that we're gonna do, we're gonna prep this early, but we're gonna put it to the side. Is our fennel. So fennel is an absolutely beautiful bit of produce. Charred, little bit of oil, all that flavor comes out. It just smells delectable. We are going to slice the bottom off here, and we are just going to cut it straight in half down the middle. And essentially, I just want to take some of the baby bits from in the middle. So like this, right? This nice little strip from the middle here. And again, keep in mind, I will reuse this. I'm not going to waste it because I do not waste food. So I think what I'm going to prepare for you tonight, I'm going to do a one lamb cut off the rack. And then what we're going to do with it is the other six cutlets I'm going to put in the slow cooker and turn into a beautiful casserole. So maybe I'll share that secret recipe with you as well. But let's just slice this down again. So I've essentially just created some really nice rustic style cuts, right? Because we're just going to char them and we need to keep like flat, right? So I just want two for the purpose of this. Again, you could leave the bottom off, clean it up and cut it straight through the middle. But I like, again, I said rustic, so I'm going to trim it up a bit, make it a little bit fancy. So that's going to be held for my casserole, which is going to be delicious as well. So we'll put these on the plate to the side. I did my dishes before this. Not that I'm a messy person that often in the kitchen, but you know those days where it's like, oh. I do have a dishwasher, but I also find that I'm very lazy with it, and I don't know why. Like, it is the most simplest thing. That's what they're designed for, but who knows. So we're just going to get these ready with a little bit of olive oil across the top, because I just want it to soak inside. I'm going to turn this one over. Oh man, I'm really excited to put these in the griddle pan. Alright. Beautiful. Delicious extra virgin olive oil. And just a pinch of salt. Just season them. Alright, and they're going to be ready for the pan for when that's nice and hot. Alright, oops, a little bit of salt. Bit of salt. Alright, so we've got our beautiful fennel ready to go. We're just going to put that to the side. The next thing we're going to do is, again, get our apple ready. So I've got a Granny Smith apple here. We're going to see a lot of green elements on the plate tonight, especially the mint creme fraiche. So what I'm going to do, I want to try and keep it as rustic as possible. So I'm just going to gonna slice down this side. We're just going to ever so slightly cut the core out. Probably better using a paring knife. Please do not cut yourself using a big knife, because that will not be good at all. Alright, so I've just cut and removed the core out there. If you do have an apple corer, that will obviously work just as well. I need to get my little bin out. I'm not prepared with my bin today. There we go, for our scraps there. And we're ever just gonna cut these into wedges, like so, because they're gonna look beautifully charred on the plate. So we'll put them with our fennel as well. Now we're gonna cook them in a griddle pan a bit later, towards the end, when the rack is ready. Now I will turn this down a little bit and I'm going to turn it back up. So I've turned this on because what we're going to do is we're going to prepare the lamb, which this lamb was purchased. This lamb rack roast was purchased by Coles this time. I was walking through the shops on the weekend and I was like, what am I going to cook for episode 4? And then I saw this lamb roast and I was like, my God, I've got it. So I just bought this one. But there is nothing wrong with buying good quality meat from Coles or Woolworths. As I've said before, I love going to the butcher. But you know, if you're in the right place at the right time, then definitely help out our Australian companies. But I do prefer shop local. Just a bit of a like disclaimer there, like I like to buy local. Alright, so what we're actually going to do is we're going to take this out. Now what I want to do is get some baking paper down. I can feel that being really hot. Again, my hand is above it, not on it. Maybe not. We've only got a little bit left. That's going on the shopping list. Baking paper, well, all right, we're gonna cut it on the board then. Never mind, ladies and gentlemen, apologies for that. Ran out of baking paper. It's unlike me, normally I have ample stocks of everything. All right, so I'm just gonna slice open the bottom there. And bring out this beautiful lamb rack roast that we have here. Look at that, beautifully cut, very nice, only a little bit of fat on the top, which is going to be great. And yeah, so let's get this ready. We're gonna essentially slice down this backbone right here. All right, and what I mean by backbone is this little bit of fat here. We're gonna take that off and we're gonna slice it across. All right, and then we're going to do some Frenching style in the middle. So So, ever so slightly, I just want to find where that fat was again, so I'm just going to come down the side all the way through. I should be able to feel the bone, obviously. Beautiful. So, perfect cut right across the top there, and ever so, we're going to bring it back, and we're just going to slice all the way through the top here, right? On the other side as well. Beautiful. And I'm just cutting away at this fat. It was a little bit thicker than I thought. But still. Absolutely beautiful piece of meat here. Alright, now I'm going to swap to a smaller knife. Just going to get a bit of a paring knife here. Alright, and we're just going to take along here. Alright, and I'm just going to cut from the front back. Alright, be careful of your knife, obviously. I just want to slide across the bones. Alright. Now, you can also get your butcher to do this for you, or you can buy ones that are already pre-Frenched if you're not comfortable with taking fat off the meat. Those potatoes are already boiling away, this is great. So, we're just going to cut through every bone, through the middle here. Alright, and we're going to take this end piece off. Alright, now I just want to ever so. Run my knife down the sides of the bones, taking the fat out of the middle. And we have it, ladies and gentlemen, a really nice lamb rack that I've just done a rough. Oh, missed a bit of fat on the end here. raw and unedited. That's how we like our Erfinder Chef videos, raw and unedited. And there we have it. So we've got a really nice lamb rack that we've just done some French cuts on. All right, and what we're gonna do is we are going to take, we cut them into some really nice two-piece lamb cutlets here. Look at that. Again, I'm just gonna do, might do two actually. The other two are gonna go in a slow cooker, make a casserole. So look at that, beautiful French style cutlets we've got here. Alright, so let's see. We're going to take that one, and we're going to take that one, and we're going to put these two on a plate in the fridge. Tomorrow morning, I'm going to put them all in a pot and make a casserole. Now, what we want to do with that hot plate that I turned on just before, we're going to put a hot pan on, we're going to get some oil, and we're going to pre-sear these lamb racks before they go into the oven. Put these other two onto a plate. I do have cling wrap, plenty of. It's not baking paper. Fridge, beautiful, beautiful produce. Put those knives in the sink. Just our oil a little bit. Beautiful. Now, we're just going to season this lamb with a little bit of salt. Right. Beautiful. And we're going to put them straight down in the pan. I bought a board that was possibly too big for my dish, but that's okay. Okay, I can hear that starting to sizzle, so we've got our pan ready for that. Luckily for us, I have another board available right here. So we're going to let that seal. So we're going to seal the lamb first before we're putting it in the oven. Now, as I said before, I preheated it to, 220 degrees. The oven does go up to 260, but 220 is just fine. And let's just check our potatoes. So, oh my God, not that knife. We use this one. They're coming close. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. You can hear the sizzle in the pan. I think I should only use one hot plate on this hot plate. As I said in the last episode, when you have both on it, it doesn't seem to distribute the heat as well. So I think we'll just use one at a time. How's that sound? So I've been looking around for a new home. I need a bigger house. Our house is too small to run a cooking show from the kitchen. Plus my little one's playroom and office and everything all in this little tiny townhouse. So I've been looking at a couple of places in the area, and I found one that I really like, and it has an amazing kitchen. And I really hope I get it so that I can record an episode of the Erfinder Chef from that kitchen, because it would be fantastic. And lots of space for Harlow's playroom, and that sort of thing, which is important. And then also office space so that I can work from home sometimes as well. Which is the company I work for, absolutely amazing with the family-friendly flexibility that they have, especially as a single parent. They're just so accepting and so willing to help out whenever I need it. It is fantastic. All right. Potatoes are coming along. Now let's just lift our lamb up here and have a look. Oh, getting a nice brown color on it. We want to get a really good brown color on it before we turn it over. And these are going to go into the oven for pretty much most of the episode. Once I put these in the oven with the roast potatoes, which will take about 25 to 30 minutes, then we're going to get started on the mint creme fraiche. And that's going to be really exciting, because just mint and fennel and lamb and apple and just one of the little recipes that I like to make, which kind of is a similar sort of thing, are lamb brioche burgers. Lamb brioche burgers. So making little lamb patties. Making a tzatziki mayo that we do with fresh zucchinis, and making the mayonnaise from scratch, that sort of thing. Really love to do that sort of thing. Making a mint slaw to go in there, so that mint, that crunch, that real fresh mayonnaise, using a light oil to bring it all together, which you can do in the food processor. And then just good little burgers that you can have just on the weekend, especially if you have like guests over, that sort of thing. I'm hoping that I can start developing this into doing a mini series for you as well, like just quick and easy recipes of like entrees. I had an entree the other day while I was actually editing episode 3. I made these char-grilled eggplant discs with some of the leftover ice fillet from episode 3, and I put a camembert wheel in the oven with a bit of the black currants from the red wine and black currant jus on top, and I just let it cook in the oven, and all the berries just fell apart on top of the cheese, and I cut the top of the cheese off first, so it really molded inside the cheese or went melty, and then I just put the eggplant discs and a nice, really thin slice of the eye fillet that I cooked up in the pan. And then I just put a dollop of the black currant camembert on top. And it was really simple, but the flavors, they just all combined together. It was kind of like a mini cheeseburger without a bun. Like, it was really quite cool. And I was just, it all came together, because when you're home and you're hungry and your mind's going like, what can I have to eat? Like, if you look hard enough in your fridge and you've got nice fresh produce, you can really make anything. I mean, yeah, we have the freezer section, this place down here where you keep your frozen meat and your boxes of chicken nuggets after your weekend hangover. But Give it a go. Like, you can make your own chicken nuggets. You get some really nice chicken breasts, cut them in the right shape, crumb them correctly, and cook them in the air fryer. Like the air fryer. My love, the air fryer. I am an appliance, just hoarder. I have a Thermomix, I've got a food processor, I've got like two blenders, I've got this cupboard is just full of appliances. I'm surprised it's not falling out. But yeah, like, I want to start making my own bread again in the Thermomix. Like, I'm just really excited with the opportunities that I have for a Thermomix. And like I said before, there's plenty of other options out there than a Thermomix. Like, apparently, the Aldi Thermomix is just amazing. And it's only, I think it was, when it was, like, there was a massive advert on it, on social media about it. And I think they were saying that it was, like, $400 or something like that, which is just epic. Epic prices. Alright, I'm going to drain these potatoes now to get ready to go into the oven with this lamb. I'll get my colander. Shut the door on the appliance cupboard. Notice I'm really focusing on the word appliance after the last episode where I, for some reason, referred to appliances as applications. I may or may not have been house hunting at the time and was thinking, oh yeah, house applications. I don't know. But all I know is when I watched the footage back, I was like, meh, raw and unedited. But what am I talking about? I'm just having fun. Blah, 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 talk. I do that a lot. Not just at home, to myself, in my own kitchen, on camera. I talk a lot at work. Just in everyday life, really. I blab a lot of stuff on the internet. You know. I'm just a really chatty guy. I'm actually really excited, so I've decided that for the next episode, I'm going to do a chicken or fish dish, and this is a request that I actually got from one of our followers on Facebook, sent me a message today, and I was quite just shocked, because we're just about to hit 300 followers, which I just think is amazing, like, you know, and a lot of my friends have gone, are those 300 people you know? No. And yeah, I've invested a little bit of money into advertising, marketing this, because, and I'm only talking about a little bit of money, like, I think I've spent maybe $100 so far on ads and marketing, and I've already hit 300 subscribers. Like, that's just, that is amazing. And then, yeah, like, I wasn't expecting to see the message this morning when I was at work, from a lovely lady who messaged asking about chicken and fish dish. So I'm going to organise something spectacular. I'll do a throw out next week on the episode. I'll tag, you know, do some tagging, and we'll do something really cool with chicken or fish. Just need to plan that out. And then I think one of the up-and-coming mini episodes that I might do for you guys is my daughter's birthday cake. So my daughter Harlow, she turns 4 soon. I'm very excited for her. I'm gonna get a photo to show you. I have photos throughout my entire house. You can probably see from my Facebook page as well. But this is my little one here. She is absolutely adorable, and I love her to bits. And she turns 4 in just over a week. So we'll be having a bit of a family party for her. And I'm going to make a rainbow layered cake with some cool little cartoon characters on it from her favourite cartoon, The Octonauts. So I think I'm going to film that and turn it into a bit of a mini series episode. So get excited for that. Otherwise, I'll post lots of pictures. I'll see how I go for time schedule. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, this lamb is looking ready to nicely go into the oven. So I'm just going to pop them onto the tray next to the potatoes. Gonna get our sea salt flakes for our potatoes. We're gonna sprinkle some salt on there, get them nice and salty, because yum. We want roast potatoes. And the other little thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get a fork. And I'm going to prod some holes in them. So just fork prods at either end of the potatoes. Right, nice. And last but not least, once I've prodded them all, right, you can take this pan off now. I'm just gonna kind of so carefully sizzle, sizzle, sizzle. We're just gonna drizzle some oil over these before they go into the oven. So beautiful oil over there. I'm feeling a little bit more relaxed tonight about this episode. You know, as I've said in my very first one, it's been like 12 years since I've done any sort of editing or recording of anything. And so tonight I'm actually wearing the chef's jacket, which is of course a just, you know, it's got to happen. But I'm also in my socks because it's comfy. I'm chill. You're at home. You don't have to wear shoes in the kitchen. Well, unless you're dangerous with knives, then obviously wear yourself some safety shoes. Obviously shoes are a must in a commercial kitchen. But you know, be careful, be safe. Don't do anything that you're not comfortable with doing unless you're practicing. You know, take time with your skills. Just learn over time, practice the same things over and over, and then you can wear socks. All right, we're gonna pop this in the oven now. So we've got our potatoes that we've just boiled in a pot of hot water. We've poached them a bit with a fork. We've put a bit of salt on them. We've put some olive oil across, and we've got the lamb racks, which we've pre-sealed on the hot plate, and we're gonna pop these straight in the oven. All right. Excellent, so they're in, ready to go. So the next thing that we're going to work on is our mint creme fraiche. Alright, so with the mint creme fraiche, I'm obviously using container creme fraiche, which I bought from Woolworths, I think it was. And I've got a beautiful bunch of mint here, which I also picked up from Coles on the weekend when I picked up the lamb rack. What we're going to do, we're just going to take massive amount of mint because we want that real punchy mint flavor. So I'm just going to, we're going to give it a good rinse first. Just going to take off a lot of the stems, a lot of the leaves off of the stems, sorry. Well, same thing, I guess. All right, trickle our bin down here. Because what we're going to do is we're going to put this in a mortar and pestle with some garlic. Right, we're gonna, oh, this mint smells amazing. I'm very excited. I love mint. Mint is just an absolute beautiful herb. Very just even steeping mint in like a teapot with some hot water helps clear the sinuses. It's just beautiful. Beautiful. And you can find, like, mint is so cheap. And normally you can find it in the streets growing in some wild patch somewhere, or you walk past somebody's front yard and there's like a massive bush of mint in their front garden. Just cut yourself a little snippet, make sure they're not watching. They could be mint fanatics and not appreciate you stealing off their mint bush. I want roughly about 2 cups here, right? Now, we're gonna have to do it possibly in bits and pieces in the mortar and pestle, maybe. Or the other thing we could do is process it in a food processor. I think it's at the front of my appliance cupboard, seeing as I used it on the weekend. All right, we've got this mint. Let's just keep going. I want an amazing green colour from this creme fraiche. Like, I'm so excited about a colour that's going to come out. and taking photos afterwards.
Oh yeah, boy.
All right. I think that'll do. All right. So I'll put this in the fridge. We'll do it in the food processor. It's at the back of the cupboard. Did not plan this one ahead, obviously. Pop the air fryer back in there. God, I really hope I get a new kitchen. I can have all my appliances on the bench. All of them. Put our fennel at the back here. We're going to get the griddle pan for that out soon. Pop in our food processor here. I'm going to take the plastic plate off. And we are going to change it out for a metal blade, which I thought I would have in this drawer. The next one. I knew I was close. I knew it wasn't back in the cupboard. Alright, so we've got our metal blade in there. Again, gonna rinse this with mint. Let's use, if we possibly can, we'll use the dishes. So we got the colander that we use to drain the potatoes. I'm just gonna rinse the mint in the sink. So you want to squeeze a lot of the water out once you have rinsed it. You don't want to have that retention water in there, right? Because otherwise a lot of that water is going to end up in your cranberry-ish. Alrighty. We're going to mint. We're going to put that straight in there. Straight into the food processor. Beautiful. Stem in there, we'll take that out. That's a big stem. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the stems. I just like the leaves. Alright, we've got this beautiful mint in here. Next, what we're going to do, garlic. Again, still going on the garlic cloves from the farmer's market. It's just amazing how well fresh produce can last. It is just amazing. Alright, where's our little, I know I washed it just before, our flat grater. So I'm just going to grate some garlic here, say about, what am I feeling like? I'm feeling like, maybe, I'm going to say 6 cloves. I like a lot of garlic, that one's a bit bigger. So 6 cloves of garlic. Beautiful. 6 cloves of garlic. Garlic. Yum, yum. Alright, so we're going to pop that in there as well. Don't waste. Or flat knife. The only thing that's been on this bench is Mint and lime. Mint and lime. We are going to put some lime in here though. Alright. Put our garlic back in the fridge. Well, I have some limes in here somewhere. Or I did have some limes in here. Yes, I did. Always have limes in the fridge because I like me a good rum dry and lime. Alright. Oh, that's my bread knife. That's not what we want. Alright. Just a quarter of a lime juice onto the fruit processor as well. And a little dash of grapeseed oil. So this is going to help break it all up. All right. So again, let's just go over. We've got garlic, squeeze of lime juice, mint, and some grapeseed oil. We are going to pop some black pepper, extra black pepper in here. Beautiful. And sea salt. Of course. Sea salt. Of course. Beautiful. Just want to check on what's in the oven. Oh, yes. I am excited. I can hear it sizzling away. It is going to be delicious. Alright, so we've got that in there, so we're just going to move this back and move this across so you guys can see. Now, last episode I had some technical difficulty with my food processor at the beginning and I wasn't sure what was going on, but it was because I didn't have the lid on properly. My mistake. Now I've learned my lesson. I know how to put it on properly. Alright, so we're just going to set it to 1. Alright, we're just going to get... Oh, yes. Now, I also do have a spatula from the Thermomix that I forgot about. I remember in the last episode, I was like, I don't have a spatula, it broke. And I do own one. So win. Alright, put the lid back on. Alright, so we've got quite a fine blend here, but obviously there's not much in here, so the system can't really blend much if there's not much in here. So what we are going to do is get ready with our creme fresh, ladies and gentlemen. Now, if you are looking for creme fraiche, you can find it in the cream section in a lot of supermarkets. Mm-mm. And essentially, creme fraiche is just cream and culture. Alright? It's very, very, very hard, but it can become very soft. And it's kind of like, you know, I'd describe it as like, sort of, like a, you know, it is what it is. It's creme fraiche, but it's like the consistency of a sort of cream cheese, almost, but it's not. Alright, so we're just going to get a spoon, we're going to put the lid on, and I think what we're going to do is get our oil as well, because I just want to get that balance with the oil and the creme fraiche, and what we're going to do is we're going to add a spoonful of creme fraiche into our food processor, possibly with the lid off might be better. We're going to put our lid back on, and then we're just going to pour a little bit of oil as it spins around, alright? Alright, so we've got our first bit in there, get exciting, we're going to add some more creme fraiche in here. And the goal here is to get that bright green colour from the mint. I almost went for a lick then, almost did a chef's lick, but I'm going to use that again, so I won't. Alright. add some more creme fraiche into here. Alright, here we go again. Pretty much want to use this whole tub. Maybe not put so much, I don't think we're going to do any oil in this next one. It's all about a play by ear again, another one of those sort of products where you play it by ear to determine the thickness as you go, right? You are in control, my friends. You are in control. And get the last of this creme fraiche out. Now it's almost the consistency of the sauce. Now watch this, I can lick this now. Going in the sink. Tastes a little bit like a sour cream, to be honest. Look at that. Now it's just got this beautiful sort of speckled green colour in it as well. Now I'm going to try it because again it's a play by ear sort of recipe. We could add some more mint in here. We're definitely going to add some more mint in there. Gonna get the mint out. Where did I put it? I actually have two bunches. Ooh. This mint I only found just before is from the farmer's market. Now look at that. That is some beautiful stems. Oh, let's chuck some of this in there. We really want that balance between the garlic. This creme fraiche that I'm making is essentially, it kind of reminds me a bit of a Greek sort of taste to it, to be honest. Lots of garlic. We've got that mint freshness. So I said 2 cups. This is roughly going to be about 3. Again, it's one of those taste and play by ear recipes, right? We really want it to combine nicely with the grilled fennel and the whole grain mustard apple, grilled apple that we're going to do, which will be the next thing that we do to prepare for plating. Alright, let's blend this up. Oh, lots of mint in there now. Mint leaf on the floor. Alright, let's go. Smell how much more mintier that is. Like, I'm almost so excited. Highly recommend, add more mint. That is delicious. The garlic element is really up to you, depending on how much you like garlic. I'm a massive garlic fan. I've done a lot of licking my fingers because got to get all the good old soap out and just wash my hands. Alright, so we've got this beautiful, beautiful. We can get a spoon so that I can put some on there and show it to you. We've got this absolutely beautiful creme fraiche. Look at that, ladies and gentlemen. I'm just hoping that bit on the end doesn't fall on the floor. Alright, so we're going to have this ready for plating very soon. I'll pop that over to the side over here. We'll get rid of our food processor. Oh, that was the wrong one. That was the hot plate. And we want to turn that hot plate on, actually, because we're going to get the charring of the fennel and the apple going, which is going to be divine. Oh my god, man, what are you doing? Trying to electrocute yourself here. Spilled beer. Sacrilege. Spilled my drink a little bit there. God, I'm a messy chef. Again, another reason why I need a bigger kitchen. More bench space. Alright, so go and see. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we have got our hot plate on ready for our charring of our fennel. I have this beautiful griddle pan here which I'm going to get ready. I'm going to pop a bit of oil in there. One last thing I am going to do with this fennel is I'm just going to trim a bit off the top. Because I don't think they're going to fit in the pan. Beautiful. I'm just going to pop them face down here at the back. I'm so excited. Alright. And we're also going to put our apple in here. So the other thing I'm going to get is a little bowl with some hot green mustard in it and a little bit of lemon juice. Okay, so I've got some whole grain Coles brand mustard here. We've got a spoon. That spoon. And just a real rough dollop, maybe two. Should have left this on, maybe. I might switch it over to the back and then I'll bring it over when it's a little bit more heated. We'll get it started on there and move it back there. Should have left it on then. I will get this. Raw and unedited. Alright. So, don't need anything out of the fridge. What I do need is our serving plate. Now, what are we going to serve it on tonight, ladies and gentlemen? I think I'm going to use the same plate that I did last week because it's just, I really like the black on it. Let's have a look. What else have we got in here? I like a variety of plates. I definitely think I'm going to use this one. All right, we'll give it a nice clean wipe. Got a nice clean cloth over here. regular. Beautiful clean.
What?
Oh, that lamb smells divine. And those potatoes are browning along nicely. We just need to char this mental blank. Fennel and the apple. Now that I've got my plate, I did save lemon juice, so we're going to add some lemon juice to the brain mustard. Just like the tiniest splash. Yeah, there's a lot of seeds in this lemon. We don't want seeds in our mustard. Pepper. To plate, ladies and gentlemen. The lamb is coming along nicely. I'm just going to give that plate a bit of a dry. Now we're looking over here. Now let's see if we can move this over. Preheat. Alright, we'll turn this one off. Alright, we've got our plate ready to the side here. Now, what I want to do with this is essentially get this massive, beautiful dollop of creme fraiche, and I'm just going to pop it here. I'm going to spread it ever so nicely across the page like that. Let's have a look how these apples and fennel are going. Yeah, we're going to leave them on that side for a little bit longer. Let's bring them all to the middle so we get the best heat out of it. Go. So what we're going to do with the whole grain mustard and the lemon and the cracked peppers, once the apples have charred, we're going to toss them through that and we're going to plate it up. Now, I'm going to take my lamb rack out because I want it to rest a little bit at room temperature. So I've turned off the oven here. I'm going to bring these over, ladies and gentlemen. You have to see these. Absolutely divine. I'm carrying a hot tray around, but look at that. I can't wait to see my camera goes. Look at that beautiful lamb French cutlets. Divine. We've got a fantastic sizzle going on our pan here. How's our fennel looking? Oh. We had that bit fall off, you know, that's okay. That's not going to go to room temperature, Ben, if you put it on a hot, hot plate, silly. Alright, I kind of want this really caramelized golden color coming out of these apples as well. You want to keep the char going one way as well. Don't change direction. It'll look weird on presentation, especially if somebody turns it over and goes, eh. Now it's being charred horizontally. Again, our beautiful mint creme fraiche that we made. And as I said before, with the creme fraiche, just taste as you go along. You really want that garlic hit, but not too much, that real mint hit. So, you know, it brings it all together. And you've got the lime juice in there. You've got the cracked pepper and the salt. You really taste the seasoning. It's just going to go really well with the lamb. Absolutely divine. Brown caramelizing on my fennel. That milk stout is divine. So much flavor. I love it. Ooh, I'm so excited by these. They look delicious. Oh, there's our apples coming. Oh, yes. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I'm so excited. Alright, we're going to take the apples out. Apples are going straight into the whole grain. Mustard with the lemon and the cracked pepper. And we're just going to give them a bit of a toss around. Beautiful. Alright, I think it's time to plate up. So, what we're going to do, ever so lightly going to put our apples on the side of our sauce. Oh, our creme fraiche. Yeah, you know what? I want four because I'm really excited about these. Alright, grab our beautiful roast potatoes and our lamb cutlets. Alright, so we're going to pop our roast potatoes at the end here. Real rustic home dining we have here. Alright. How's our fennel coming along? Oh yes. Alright, we've got this beautiful char grilled fennel right here. We're just going to pop that to the side. Oh, the apple fell down. And last but not least, we're going to top it off with our beautiful French style lamb rack roast. And there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. another classic rustic dish at home. We have a lamb French cutlet with a beautiful grilled fennel, a whole grain mustard and grilled apple with roast baby potatoes and a mint creme fraiche. All right, I'm so glad to have brought another rustic home cooked meal for you. And again, I'm so excited about doing more and more episodes and sharing more and more ideas with you guys. Again, look forward to next episode. We're going to do a chicken or fish dish. I'm not too sure yet. We're going to do some shout outs and some tags. It's really quite exciting. But yeah, I can't wait to see you guys again. Thank you so much for coming to my episode. I'm going to take some pretty pictures of this meal right now for the Facebook page and the YouTube channel. And then I'm going to absolutely just devour this amazing meal. All right, and I really hope that you guys give this a try. Remember, I'll be putting the episode sheets up on the weekend for this recipe. So please comment, let me know if you give it a shot. I'd really like to get some feedback on it from you guys. But thank you again for joining me here at the Erfinder Chef, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Have a great evening. Thank you.